If I press Command K and type this in, it will fix the icon function. Hello folks, welcome to today's video. We're going to be diving into Notion Calendar and giving you everything you need to know about this experience. Now, for those who don't know, Notion Calendar has been launched and Notion have taken Cron, which was their former calendar application that they bought in 2022, and turned it into Notion Calendar. In today's video, we're going to show you everything you need to know, including how to change the app icon, how to use the scheduling links, how to set up Notion databases, and much more to improve the functionality. If you're curious whether Notion Calendar is right for you, you can use our resource toolfinder below to search all the calendar apps and the best calendar apps on the market. If you're in the hunt for a new one, or you are searching and want to look deeper into Notion Calendar as a whole. So here we are with Notion Calendar, and first and foremost, you can connect Google Calendar as many as you like, and Notion Calendar is free, very much like the Cron counterpart before. And it has a few abilities that a lot of people will like. The first is the beautiful design that makes it really easy to use, but sharing availability is the next one that is speedy and functional in this application. So to share availability, you can press S on your keyboard, and the keyboard sort of goes, the site sort of goes gray, and you can pick slots that you want and choose the calendar in which you want to connect it up to. Now, what's really nice is you can connect it to your Notion database as well. So it's by two-way syncs, which is very helpful. We'll show you more of the Notion abilities later. And you can connect up conferencing with Google Meet and Zoom using the settings page, which I'll show you a little later as well. But here we are, you can actually create a scheduling link, and as you can see, a couple of dates which you can paste in your calendar, or you can go ahead and create it. Now that snippet was copied to the calendar, sorry, the clipboard, so it means I can share it wherever I am, whether that's a social media app or however I need it. And you can see all the dates here are held until those ones have been chosen, which are perfect for making sure you don't double book yourself as well. Now, next thing to note is that the viewing options are very nice. You can go into number of days and you can choose between 2 to 9, and you can even choose maybe even 10 days if you want to. Now, I like the 3-day view. It's a nice window into the week and allows you to see what's ahead. And over this left-hand side, I can coordinate all of the calendars that I'm part of. Now down here, you may notice that there's a keep productive area and I've got SEO content selected on. Now this was the release for the Notion calendar. So what I wanted to do was connect up the database that is connected to that. So you can see here, once that database is connected, anything that is calendar based that has a date associated to it will essentially bring this item into the Notion calendar experience. As you can see in Notion, it allows you to bring that edit date in and it moves it about too. So for demonstration purposes, if I move the date forward, you can see the edit date has changed, which means that two-way sync is available, which means that you can be in your calendar and move a deadline forward, and you can even choose a specific time and date, which makes that helpful too. Next up, if you're looking to connect a Notion page to make it easily accessible, one thing you can do, for example, record an edit session. I have a YouTube schedule link here, and that'll basically open up instantly the YouTube schedule that I need to go through. Now, what's really nice is I can add more documents, and you can search across all of your workspaces that are connected, even the most recently searched ones, or you can find which one you want in the search. It's a little bit slow, but it works pretty well in terms of getting things going. This is great when you're sharing stuff in Teams because you can connect the Notion pieces that people might want to easily access, like meeting agendas and things like that. This also works well in the two-way sync because you can connect up meeting notes with stuff through the Notion database before, and it allows you to just connect all your meetings with your current calendar. Let's go over to settings. There's a range of settings that can help you enhance your experience, like turning weekends off, allowing you to see declined events, and having week numbers on there. I like week numbers on there. But you can also set your day from Monday. You can press and use the keyboard commands to save a little bit of time. And there's some items about context in the terms of meetings and terms of the light and dark mode, which you can switch between here. Now, notifications are easy to set up. Menu bar gives you an extensive way to see upcoming items on your calendar without going forward. And also, you can connect up all your Google calendars here, which is something that is very helpful. And finally, from here, you can set up your Zoom and custom links if you have another third-party video conferencing alternative. Now with Notion, you can connect up your workspaces here. I've got two workspaces set up and you can have multiple set up and you can set up which one's a default here as well. So a lot of people have been complaining about the logo, new Notion logo calendar I personally don't like, but there's a way to change it. The developer, the original founder, Raphael, shared this on Twitter, but all you have to do is press Command K and type this in. I'll put the actual text in the description below, but essentially that will turn the icon back to the Cron icon that you had before with the relevant date on it. So other things you can do with Command Bar is you can type in P and essentially you can see the availabilities of other people's schedule. For example, other people who work with you, which is helpful. You can search all of the Notion databases that you have connected to your account. This means that you can see the calendar items attached to it. And finally, you can change your time zone as well, which gives it an additional time zone, or change the time zone that you're currently in. So folks, I hope that was a good overview of Notion Calendar. If you're in the hunt for a calendar application or unsure about Notion Calendar, you can find everything in terms of resources below. Hopefully it was helpful. We'll do some more time blocking, maybe some Notion database intent stuff with meetings and how to optimize it. A little bit further on, this is much more of a beginner's insight into how to get started. So thank you very much. Make sure you hit subscribe. If you're new here to keep productive, we do plenty of videos covering all productivity tools, but naturally a couple on Notion too. So I hope this helped and I'll see you all in a future video. Cheerio.